Okay, it's 9:00. Pledge allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning.
Good morning, everybody.
Morning.
Can I have a motion to approve the Commissioner's minutes of May 16th?
I'll make a motion.
Okay, motion has been made.
A second.
Second. Motion has been made and second to approve the minutes. Any corrections or anything? None. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Claims. Harley? Harley? Hang on a second. I'm in a meeting right now, part of County Commission. That's it. All right, goodbye.
I'm gonna ask that we hold off on approving the claims for about 10 minutes while two more get entered.
Okay. Okay. Then we'll go to monthly treasures report.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'll have your report there in front of you. Questions, let me know. I think we need a motion to approve.
Make a motion to approve the treasures report.
Can I have a second to approve it? Need a job? Okay, motion has been made and second to approve the treasures report. Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Did you say that?
Okay, partial permit?
Partial permit. Any bridge call, Mr. Becky?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay, come on up.
Asking for a payment plan schedule for my property taxes.
Okay.
The only reason I'm behind is because of medical problems I've had. I was only here 6 months, and right after that, three surgeries right back to back. Two of mine was died. So, and one I actually did die. So, it brought me back. Thank you. But that's the only reason I'm in the predicament I'm in. Because I was working, I was paying my property taxes on time, and then I fell ill, and then while I was trying to recover from that, I had another illness with surgery, and then recovering from that, another. I haven't been able to work. I'm 4.5 years into the Social Security plan.
What would be a realistic plan that you think you could do?
I know I could make $100 minimum. I mean, that would be the amount I know I can make.
Okay.
And if I have any extra money, I can make more. But right now, I'm only on $757 a month, service-connected disability.
And what would be the best time for you to make your payment then?
The first, when I get my service-connected
disability.
How about
if we make it like on the 5th? That way, in case something happens, but you don't get an automatic deposit or something. So on the 5th, and what month would you want to start?
I can start right now. I got $100 in it.
Are you a disabled veteran?
Yes, I am, but I'm only 40%. They won't give me any more percentage unless I totally lose my hearing or my kidneys.
Okay.
So but I have filed for Social Security as, SSI. I'm 4.5 years in. I just saw the judge April 12th. He said I couldn't do any jobs that I've previously done, but he hasn't ruled on it yet. And that's all the way to being a bookkeeper, too. So even minimum exertion jobs, he didn't allow.
So then does the commission want to entertain a motion to accept $100 a month payment starting June? We'll put back date to June 5th, but if you want to make your payment today,
yes,
it'll take roughly 20 months to catch up.
Yes, I hope to be caught up way before that, because as soon as they decide something on my disability claim, if they give me any back pay, it'll go straight to my property taxes to get that all paid.
I'll make the motion to accept $100 per month starting June 5th.
Second. Okay. Motion has been made and second to approve $100 a month for June 5th. Okay. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Okay.
That's 815 Second Avenue East, Lowbridge.
Thank you for your service.
Thank you very much
for your service.
Thank you. I appreciate you guys helping make that payment. Hopefully I should be caught up before the end of the year, but fingers crossed it'll actually approve my claim after 4.5 years. So thank you very much.
Take care of your health first.
I'm trying to. Thank you.
You call that my disability health.
Okay, discussion on taxi properties.
I'm just passing out my last one I typed up this morning. Things change on it constantly. So the very first taxi property I visited with her son. He lives in Minnesota, and he visited with her, and they would like the county to take that property. Been condemned by the city of Java. And so I talked to Jamie.
And basically, it would speed the process up. We're going to take it anyhow, is just take a deed from them. This is a property, I think you all know about it, in Java, and this might be a good companion one to remove when we remove that other building in Java, since we're going to open the rubble site. But that's down the road, but realistically, you might as well just take a deed from them. It would be speed the process up, make it simpler, easier on everyone.
Make it clear.
Yeah, they just give the county a quick claim deed. And then we would go ahead, because we're going to take the property anyhow. So,
you mean in motion to that effect?
No, I just want to make sure that it's okay with the commission that we go that route before we go ahead and do it. So we'll do that.
Okay, the next two on the list, both owners are deceased. The last person that paid the payment is deceased. They do have renters in there. I called the state and visited with Jamie, and it sounds like we need to advertise in the paper and just get the ball rolling on that one.
And we did. I did speak with the renters, and there was a person that was in the process of trying to get a purchase agreement and a contract for deed with these people before they were deceased. It never came through, and the tenants do know that somewhere down the road they'll probably be told they can no longer reside in the property because they don't think the county wants to be in the landlord business. So they're aware of that too, that somewhere down the road it will be taken and it'll be a county possession. So everybody's kind of, but this is a unique one since all of the property owners are deceased. We just have to.
Where is this at?
And it's a house, and then there's a lot next to it, and it's in Mulbridge. Do you have the street address?
I do. This is 409 8th Avenue East.
What is it?
409 8th Avenue East.
You know that place where the U-Haul trailers are? It's a house right south of there.
Well, if there are people in there paying rent, who are they paying rent to?
The person who is trying to buy it. Yeah, that's a whole
that's
other
a good question.
That's a whole other issue.
What gives him the right to collect money on property?
That's a legal issue I'm not going to get into, but you kind of have a concern there, yes. I don't know how the agreement got entered into or why they're doing
so. When would we start taking this property?
I'd put it in paper this week. You have to be 60 days.
I would say let's get it put in as soon as possible so we're not having people out there getting money for
it. I mean, just send forms to the renters. They have to sign it, send it back. 60 days after I get all the paperwork back. It's all ready to be mailed out. Okay.
I would say
just
wanted to visit with you guys first.
Let's get going on this as soon as we can, so.
Okay.
Just out of curiosity, what is the tax on this?
That's due. How much they owe?
I think it's fairly significant.
Is it?
It is. I have it here.
I'm just curious.
Must be worth something if they got renters.
$3,508.95.
Well, if the renters would pay that tax, then we wouldn't be having this discussion.
True, but the...
Because they have no right to it.
The next one on the list is also deceased. Her son stopped in and visited and made a payment. And since then, I haven't been able to contact him. If anybody knows anything about them, please let me know how to get hold of him.
Still around
here. How much was it on that?
$750. He made it quite a payment. He made $1,000. I believe we'll come through on that. And then down on the bottom of the list are the ones that I've visited with the people. They're coming in to pay soon. It's coming in. Some are waiting for their tax return. Different situations. So we will be working on those in about a month if they don't show up. Just wanted to let you guys know.
One will be in this morning.
Yes. Two more are coming this week. One is more than later this week. They're telling us.
So this would pretty much clean up all of your books?
Well, we still have the ones that are barred by statute and on treasurer's.
Pretty much everything else.
Up to the years we're taking. Yeah.
And that's the soonest we can take, correct?
No, we can take 3 years.
Okay.
This would be 5 years at this point.
That's what I was getting to is.
So technically,
we need to entertain the motion to change it from 5 years to 3 years.
I would prefer if the commissioners would approve that I only do 2 years at a time, so next year I do 4 or 5, and then the following year I could do 2 years at a time and then get to 3 years. If that's all right.
It's a lot of process for Nyla to...
And to do a good job at it, you have to spend the time.
And you have to be out of law, yeah.
I mean...
But yeah, we're in the process.
I would be willing to do it either way to make it easier, but waiting 5 years to take a property, I think, is just...
Jamie, what's the legal part of
that? We're going to have to publish notice, go through the process. So it takes about, 90 days, Nyla? 90 to 120?
Which process to?
The tax deed process.
Yes. Are you talking changing the years? Or? I don't think there's a process to that.
No, we've just been kind of always running.
It's a decision, isn't it?
Yeah. So it kind of sounds like what Nyla is saying is the goal is to get 2012 done, and then next year do 13 and 14, and then the year after that will be 14 and 15, and then we'll be caught up.
And then that's when you would consider changing it to three years then?
Yep.
Slowly, 1 year.
Do we need a motion for that?
No.
Okay.
We just wanted to inform you where we're at. Where we're at in the process and the ones that we'll be going after in this batch of...
So you went from what, 39 to 13, so we're getting
there. Pretty good.
Good job.
It's just a long, it's a long, not so much for me, but it's a lot of paperwork for Nyla to go through this process. So
Jamie gets a lot of questions.
And trying to locate them and making sure we have all the paperwork right, but yeah.
I really, and thanks for getting everything cleared up, but in my mind, I think we'd be way better off starting in 3 years and then waiting for 5 years. That other 2 years, if they're not going to pay it in 3 years, they're obviously not going to pay it in five. So why wait the other 2 years?
And that's the goal of work too, is get it down to 3 years over the next couple of cycles, and that way we'll be down to 3 years and not have to be out with it 5, 6, 7 years like we were on some of these.
Thanks, Niall.
You're welcome.
Over here, the protection team request for dental and donation. Is that you guys?
That's us.
Are you on the board?
Hi, I'm Kirsten Lundquist. I work with Child Protection.
And I'm Abigail Batt, and I work with CPS and with the Child Protection team.
So I have a printout for everybody to take one and pass on. This just goes over our Delta Dental van that we have come to town. But what the Child Protection Team does is we provide for families in need in the 5 surrounding counties. We help out families if they need help with their rent or need clothing or diapers or food. And then we also do various things in the community like the Delta Dental Van. And if you look at this, it goes over how much production value and how much money we put towards the community with the Delta Dental Van. So what happens is we pay $2,500 towards this service, and then for example, last year we served people and they did 50 patients and they did total production value of $42,597. And then there's the year before in 2015 it shows, and in 2014, so our production value has gone up significantly. And this is for any families that don't have insurance or have Medicaid. In Mulbridge, we don't have a dental service that accepts Medicaid. So this is really for a lot of those families that they can't travel anywhere else to get their children's teeth checked or worked on.
The Dental Van serves children ages 0 to 18. It's run by Delta Dental. They have two different vans that they bring to different communities. They spend a week here. They can do some basic dental services like cleanings, fluoride treatments. They can do tooth extractions, fillings, some like basic stuff. As far as like further like root canals, bridges, some of those kind of things, they would have to refer to another dentist. But this is a way for children who don't have dental insurance or families who can't afford it to be able to get at least their children's teeth checked and kind of get some of those basic services completed for them. So yeah, like Kirsten said, our portion that we pay towards it, Delta Dental, they partner with other philanthropic organizations. As the site partners, Child Protection Team has agreed to pay $2,500. And so we're here just asking for a donation of $500 from the county. As we are a pretty small organization, and like Kirsten said, we do other services for individuals through basically Walworth County is kind of primarily where the Child Protection Team focuses. So
where would the van would be located in Mulbridge?
The van would be located in Mulbridge. They would park at the high school is what we've done for the past few years. And then the high school partners with us, allows them to use the electric and use the library inside where they can do set up a cleaning station, and then also where we can set up like a spot for people to check in kind of a waiting room area. And actually, I also talked to Jessie Hafner with the Lions Club, and she said that the Lions Club wanted to do vision screenings at the same time, so that service is going to be offered at the same time, free to the families that are there.
Is that what we done last year?
Yes.
Yep. Jamie, do you think that we could take this out of the board budget?
Actually, you probably could.
Because it's...
Because our poor relief budget is really
looking
not
good.
Looking really good. So yeah, I think you could probably take it
there's
out of poor relief.
$64,000, and they're only 5% of the budget's been used so far this year.
Knock on wood, you've had a good year so far. So
I'll make a motion.
Okay, a motion has been made.
I'll second.
For $500?
Yes.
Can we include in the motion to take it out of poor budget, please?
And taken out of the core budget. Okay. Motion has been made and seconded for $500 out of the core budget. Any discussion on this? Yeah.
Can people from out of county come in?
Yes.
The way that we set it up, we do advertisements for it. The majority of the people that we serve are from Walworth County, from Walworth and Selby areas. Basically, the way that we have it set up is that we advertise for it, and then the week before, people can call and make appointments, and it's on a first-come, first-served basis. There's another one. I know they also go to Loch Paula, and I don't know what other surrounding communities they go to. So generally, what we've seen, because we've done it for 3 years, that most of the people are coming from either right there in Mobridge or Selby, just the very small surrounding communities.
Is there an income limit on it?
No. The income data that they have listed here, it's basically just like data that they gather. They don't have to meet any sort of income guidelines if they have insurance. They can also utilize the service, and then the insurance company gets billed for it as well. But it's really meant primarily for individuals who don't have insurance, or maybe they have Medicaid and are not able to get into the local dentist.
Have you had anyone that had insurance before, do you know?
Like once or twice over the course of the 3 years that we've done it. I've only seen one or two people who've come in that have had insurance. Otherwise, the rest of them either don't or they're on Medicaid.
Okay, motion has been made and seconded. Any more discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All agree. Clear, get your check.
Thank you so much. Would June 20th be okay for that check to be written, or does it need to be
today? No, that would be fine. We just have to have it paid by the time that they're here. So June 20th would be fine.
Well,
do I need to send you an invoice or something?
If you could send something for us to attach to our voucher.
What date is the plan date?
It's going to be the last week in July. I think it's like the 23rd.
Yeah, July 25th through 29th. Where that was
yeah.
Last
year. I think it's like the 23rd through the 27th or something like that this year.
24th through the 28th.
Yep.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
Thank,
thank
you.
You.
Thank you. Okay. Discussion regarding the community health contract.
Support to them. I did check with the CFO to see what they get from our surrounding counties, and the response was they get $2,000 from Campbell County and $3,600 from Corson County, but they are separate contracts for specific services.
What have we given them in the past?
This year, I believe, is $36,000.
Okay.
year is 36,000.
The other counties are giving 3,600.
Well, Corson County does, and then Campbell County gives 2,000, but those are for specific services, you said. So it's not just for their contract. I don't know what those specific services are.
It's a big difference.
So we need a motion to go 36.
How did that come up with the 36, or how was it determined?
Well, we've always given money to them, and then just over the years, they've asked for increased for inflation, things like that. If you look at your big packet that was given to you this morning. $14,000, we gave them $33,925, $15,034,950, $16,036,000, $17,036,000.
What page are you on there? Didn't take you long to find that.
I know. I went right to it. 31. That was locked right there.
What's the county's benefit out of this?
That must not be the same
thing. I tried to review this whole thing. I couldn't understand what the county benefits are.
32.
Well, and we can get Renee back here and maybe the community health nurse to explain further what they actually provide for Walworth County as opposed to other counties and things like that if you would like. We can have them here at the next meeting.
That one time they had community health nurse actually had an office in the courthouse. It was down where the sheriff's office is. And she was here a certain number of days a month. I don't even know if they come to Selby.
Not that I'm aware of, because then after that they were on Main Street. I know that. They do all the WIC services and things like that, I believe.
I think they used to be here like once a week, I think, in the office. Like I said, I don't know if they even come to Selby at all.
So possibly the best thing to do
I would like to see us table it until we can get them here to actually see why we're paying so much more than other counties and what the county benefit of it would actually be.
And they did used to provide
I can't understand what the county benefit is, really, what they're providing for $36,000.
So I will get them here next meeting?
I would make a motion to table it until we could get them here to find more information out of it instead of just this handout. Because I don't see the benefit that we're getting out of it for $36,000.
Okay, motion has been made to table it.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. And then we have the next meeting. Okay, sign the countywide stripping agreement with the state.
Striping.
Well, we can strip too.
No. Striping.
Striping?
Striping.
Striping. But it's actually stripping.
We'll
strike it.
Swamp striking. I just need a motion to sign this. There's two of these, Becky. They both have to be signed. They both have to be mailed back in the mail. It's the state striking program. Huh?
This is our annual agreement.
Oh, yeah. We do this every year.
And I have a motion to approve. Okay, second.
Motion
is made in second to approve the striking agreement.
Thank you.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
You gotta pay for it.
Yeah, right.
The only other thing I wanted to let you know that Joe Fiedler started on May 30th. His pay rate will be $12.55 an hour. He works every summer for us as more and helps with chip sealing and stuff. So.
$12.55?
Yeah.
And what was the date?
May 30th. And that's all I got.
Thank you.
And you're welcome.
Okay, consider motion to do an automatic supplement in the amount of $3,225.85 for the insurance claim.
We need to table that until the next meeting. We were under the impression we had a $500 deductible, and when we received the check from the insurance, we only had $250 deductible for comp. So it's the incorrect amount here, so we're just going to table it and put it on the next agenda to do the supplement with the correct amount.
Do we need a motion to table that?
Yeah.
Okay, motion has been made to table that. Second. Okay, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Okay. Okay, well, we're a little bit ahead of time. Can you take over there? Landfill and courthouse issues?
I don't know if I can bring up half an hour, maybe about 5 minutes. We do have some vehicles and some other items of value that we should consider a disposal method for, whether we do an auction or we do sealed bids. That's kind of what I wanted to get some input on. I think we have, you had two trucks, right, Penny? We had two other vehicles, so that's four vehicles. We had that the PTO wet kit. Tires, I think we talked to, just going to do by the piece, right?
Yeah.
So those wouldn't have to be auctioned. Unless you wanted to throw something on there.
If we do an auction,
yeah.
Then I probably would.
Okay.
If we're just going to sell them and no.
Okay.
I guess my opinion, I think we should just do a sealed bid on it. We wouldn't make any money if we have an auction sale. All go to, maybe we'd be better off just seal bidding it and move on.
Yeah, that's something that we can, that's something
take
we can certainly
it.
Do.
How many vehicles would that be?
Four vehicles and then the PTO wet kit. I think that would probably be all that we would solicit bids for, I think.
By the time you pay for the advertising and everything.
Oh, we're
going to
be paying for advertising.
Yeah, but I'm asking.
And the auctioneers.
Auctioneers.
Well,
we could do auctions without an auctioneer, too.
But,
you know, that with that limited number of items, we could. I'll just have to look, make sure. I don't remember for sure if you do seal bids, if you have to do an appraisal on the items.
Yes.
Okay, you do it with seal bids. Auction, you don't have to appraise.
Is there a consignment auction around somewhere that we could take them to?
I think it's too late. There just was one, wasn't there, Dwayne?
Yeah, Clarence had his.
A consignment auction?
I think that one's already done.
Yeah, a couple of weeks ago.
You can talk to Preston or somebody about it.
I don't think we need to hire an auctioneer and pay for that. Well, we got five items.
Yeah, five. We could probably come up with some more, give us a little bit of time here, too. But
we don't have enough to draw a crowd.
I wouldn't think
no.
So, if not for four whole used up vehicles. And
we'd be better off with just bids, I can say.
So, if we do it that way, we do have to get all those items appraised then, which means designating three appraisers and just going through and filling out evaluation forms for each item.
They have to be property owner and taxpayers.
Yep.
It's just like we do when we surplus our plate.
Yeah. So, Commission wants to designate
okay.
Those people.
Who's interested in doing that? Penny? Brian, would you too?
I can't. I don't own property all this time.
Oh,
so.
Okay.
I can.
You can? Okay. There we have Penny. State's attorney. Anybody else?
I can't if you're.
you.
We need three.
Somebody else. Don't matter to me.
Okay. Okay, we got three. All right. Okay.
That's about all I have for right now until the bid openings. I'm working through the process for permitting the rubble site. I just need a little bit more information, and then I should be able to have that ready to go for your guys' signature, hopefully at the next meeting here, so we can get that submitted to the state. The one thing that maybe, Scott, you can help me out with this. I don't know if you... I think Norm Thorstenson owns the property across the road, right?
Mm-hmm. To the east then?
Yeah, to the east. Within 1,000 feet, we need to have written permission from the adjacent landowners in order to go in under the general permit requirements for a rubble site. Otherwise, it has to be processed as an individual permit, and that gets more complicated. So I don't know if you... I could draft up a letter. I don't know if you know him, if you got a good relationship with him, and you could just give it to him for his signature. If Jamie wants to draft up a letter or whatever, we can work on it together.
I
and then just get, you know, I really don't know him at all or anything like that. So,
I'll do it.
Okay.
Just give me the letter.
Yep. So if we can do that, and then that'll help things out a lot. Hopefully that'll smooth the process up a bit, as long as I can get the rest of the...
Yeah, I'll do it.
Okay.
We can do 11 and 12, and then I'll grab Brenda for the order. So you still got a lot.
Okay.
Let's do 12 first.
Do 12 first.
I'm going to go grab let Brenda know she's up earlier.
Register of deeds for Warren County.
Nice
move. Okay, you want to move? Okay. She moved. She seconded the mic in there. Right, he seconded it.
And Miller and Schilling?
Yeah. No.
Yeah.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Are we going to get somebody there?
When's coming down to give you?
Okay, until they're here. Okay, can I have a motion to is that Casey or Casey?
Casey.
Thomas. To the register of deeds, signature card at Bankwest.
I'll make that motion.
Okay. Motion has been made and seconded to put Casey in as the bank card. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay.
Is she still part time?
She is as of now. I was going to put on the next agenda to ask for her to go part time.
Is she coming up?
Yep.
County Register of Deeds
to the Office of County Register
registered deeds of Walworth County, South Dakota.
Of Walworth County, South Dakota.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support.
That I will support.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of South Dakota.
And the Constitution of the State of South Dakota.
And that I will.
And that I will.
Faithfully and impartially.
Faithfully and impartially.
Discharge all the duties.
Discharge all the duties.
Of my said office.
Of my said office.
Of county registered deeds.
Of county registered deeds.
Becky, here we'll need an unapproved copy of that. So if you need to change it here.
Delicious.
Congratulations.
Number 20, or do we want to start discussing number 10?
We can do that, I guess. Let's go to 10.
Okay.
Discussion 4-H youth advisor position.
Brendan, did you hear that?
You can start. I'm sure she's on the way up. I know she was on the phone.
I know we've talked with Campbell County about it. They agree that 4-H is an important deal. We don't have one now. It'd be a great time to get a full-time person in there. And we're going to have a conference call with Campbell County at 11 o'clock. Do we want to split with Campbell County, or do we want to have one ourselves? That's what we got to decide.
You're saying us have a full-time of our own?
Have a full-time of our own, or split with Campbell County, where they'll be in both counties.
I think Brenda was saying that it'd be a full-time. She would recommend a full-time if we do 50-50 with Campbell, and then a part-time if Campbell County doesn't want to join. And we just break off from that. But I would verify that with her, a 20-hour job.
I spoke with Lisa in Campbell County, and clearly our benefits would be better, so they would be considered our employee. And then they would just pay us if we do, or we split with them.
Okay, that was one of the questions that they had, is for you guys to get together and see which benefits package, if it's full-time, which would be better.
Ours would be better, however, the issue is I cannot give Campbell County a set number on how much the benefit part of it will cost them every month
until we get a hire,
until we know who's hired because of the age.
But I know that was one of their questions about spending more time in Campbell or Walworth.
Exactly. It's going to balance out.
When my wife, when we moved up here, my wife worked with both Campbell County and Walworth County, and I don't think you have to worry about half-time and half-time, because if you get a good person in there, they're going to work with both of them. And I just think that's a non-issue. Who's going to have the most amount of time? Because if my wife put in time in both places, actually she started with four counties to begin with, and it was down to two counties. So I think if we hired somebody and did half-time and half-time, that would be fine. Because I don't see any other way that we're going to do it.
Because most of the events that are put on, they're invited to either county that puts them on, so.
Well, they pretty much just work together.
Yeah, right.
But like I said, I think when we have this conference call, the issue is going to be they're going to want to know how much it's going to cost them for the benefit portion of it. And
they know
that
it's going to depend on the age.
Mm-hmm. And
because that got brought up at our last meeting with them, is Well, what's it gonna cost? Well, we won't know until we hire somebody. Because the age difference is gonna be the difference of what benefits are gonna be.
Would that be a big difference in expense?
It could be. It could be depending on.
Let me grab this for you to look at.
These are our rates for this year, and it's age-based, so if you have someone that ends up being 23 with no kids, it's not going to be very expensive, but if you end up with someone 49
that's per month.
With three kids, it could get expensive.
Mm-hmm.
So it is a huge difference.
I guess I didn't realize it would be that big a difference.
Just for the landfill?
Do you have a bid?
Yeah, I dropped it off.
Okay, perfect. So
what's your guys' opinion? You want to partner up with Campbell County?
I would suggest that.
Yeah. You know,
full-time?
One full-time employee.
I think the benefits of having somebody full-time would far exceed having one part-time.
Yep.
They'd be way more involved at the state level and everything else. The problem with that is a lot of times you can get paid through SDSU, full-time you can't. But SDSU will still help us out with the program. We just won't receive any financial aid from them. My suggestion would be partner up with Campbell County and get a full-time.
I agree.
So that's what we're to tell him at 11 o'clock.
Okay, what are you thinking?
I am.
Yep.
You're okay. Okay.
Okay.
I have a question for you though. What if Campbell County only wants to do a part-time, like 10 hours with them and 20 with us? I think that's been batted around with them.
I guess that's not how I took it the last time.
Okay,
I took it.
Okay, good.
Talked to him last meeting.
And when I talked to Lisa, it sounded like they were just wanting to know who had the better benefits and things like that, whose employee was actually going to be.
At our last meeting, we need somebody.
While we're waiting here, I'd just like to thank the commission for closing the courthouse last year. That was a very nice thing to do. Rip off that plant from yesterday to get back to the courthouse.
Want to take a 10-minute break?
Okay. Okay, 10 o'clock, we'll be back in session. And now we're going to have a bid opening for the landfill construction, is that right? Risky, is that correct?
Yep.
Okay.
total worth of work in progress? Is that your total bid?
No, it should be in the first packet.
On the first page.
Yeah, first. Well, halfway through, I think it is.
$696,624.
$600 what?
$696,624.
Graytech?
Yes.
They're from
Berthold, North Dakota.
$764,619.07. Is that correct?
Yes.
And this essential specialties from Alexander, Minnesota. $1,160,535. Or no, $535. $1,160,535.
That's all of them, Becky?
Yes.
Okay. I'd ask that you make a motion to table so we can give the engineer time to tabulate the bids and make sure that all the technical specifications are in order.
Motion has been made to table this until the specs are all done and everything like that.
I'll second.
Second? Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay.
Didn't you just buy a new washing machine for over, or am I I know Josh isn't here, but I mean, I thought we had bought a new one.
I thought one went to pot.
Oh, well, I'm guessing it must have, but I mean, I'm just wondering. I thought it was new.
This was bought
shortly after when we did that remodeling.
We bought a new one, and I don't know which one went bad. We bought a new one when we redone the garage, and we bought a new one about a year before that.
I guess I just thought that any more than I thought he was going to have a pretty good one that we probably had some warranty on it. That's all I was asking.
I'm thinking they buy as good a one as they can get without going commercial, like a laundry mat would. And I don't remember, they told me what them cost.
Oh, yeah.
You can buy a new pickup for you for what them cost.
I just thought that if we could have a better warranty than that, I guess.
But if you don't get commercial ones, and you're doing a commercial deal like this, you're going to get warranty. Warranty doesn't go for it. That's kind of stuff.
That's been about 2 years anyway, isn't it, Kevin?
Just we did the garage.
Okay.
I'll make a motion.
Okay, motion's been made.
I'll second.
Pay all claims in the second. Any other discussion?
I'm just worried about all the overtime that we're getting.
That's not included in this right now.
It is. It's part of our claims that
I went, when I was in Aberdeen, I went and talked to Nelson over there, and he does all of the scheduling and everything like that. And I talked to county commissioners over there, and I said, what do you do with overtime and stuff like that? And they said, you cannot adjust overtime, especially in jail, because you don't know if somebody's not going to be there and who's going to pick up and anything like that. And they said, there is no way that you are going to... you can't control that. They said, and when I talked to those guys over there, they said that the jail is a revolving door over in Aberdeen. And they said, there's no way that you can.
Well, I'm going to put it on the next agenda to discuss this because.
Okay, we're not discussing that right now. All those in favor of paying the claims, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no.
Nay.
Passed. Okay. Now,
thanks for having me. Just wanted to give you an update about our forwarding. I handed out a two-page bill to everybody, and I want you to know before we start that these are all at Medicaid rates, so they've already been reduced down to the lowest possible form. Codified, South Dakota codified law does say that if I get a Medicaid rate that is lower than what the hospital is asking, that that's what I can pay. I can pay the lowest rate, whichever one is the lowest. I have these cases at the very beginning that are still ongoing, and the attorney for Avera is asking for a determination. 16B10 and 16B11 are the same individual. There is two incidents deceased as of now. And both instances were emergency. There was something that needed to go to the hospital right now. At this time, I have sent two family members twice and not received any reply back. I've sent to a significant other and received no reply back. And what I know of the individual is very little. So at this point, if we are needing to reply to the attorney, my suggestion after talking with Jamie about this would be at this time to say we cannot make a determination because we have not received anything back from family members.
Okay. So you need a motion to deny 16B10 and 16B11 at this time for no information available to make a determination.
Okay,
I'll make the motion.
We'd have to do one at a time.
Yep. Right?
Okay, a motion for case number 16B10 to deny. A motion has been made. Second. Okay, motion has been made and seconded. Any discussion? Motion has been made and seconded to deny 16B10. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Okay, 16B11.
I'll make a motion to deny 16B11.
Okay, motion has been made to deny 16B11. Second?
Second.
Okay. Motion has been made and seconded. Any discussion? Motion has been made and seconded to deny 16B11. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Our next case is 15A1 and 15A2, again the same individual. After getting information from this individual and filling out the ability to pay form by myself, they would not qualify. The first instance, 15A1, was an emergency loan, and the cost, if we would lose or pay this one, would be $2,727.36. Case 15A2 is connected again to the same case, and the cost to the county is substantially more, but this was a pre-scheduled surgery. It was non-emergency. It was something that did need to be done, but it was not like I would die right now on the spot if I did not get treatment. There was no prior authorization. I suggest I'm looking for two motions for the first one. A decision whether on that the individual does not qualify for assistance, and then a motion for 15A2 that not only did the individual not qualify, it was pre-scheduled, non-emergency, no prior authorization.
Okay. Motion for 15A1 to deny.
I make a motion to deny 15A1.
Second. For ability to pay.
For ability to pay. Okay, second by Jim. Okay, motion has been made and second to deny for ability to pay. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Okay. 15A2.
I make the motion to deny 15A2 for not qualifying and the ability to pay.
Okay, second?
I'll second.
Okay, motion has been made and second to deny 15A2. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Okay, then voluntary mental health rules. I thought I would give.
We've got to do the.
Sorry.
Okay. It's, bid opening for waste tire removal disposal.
I have these in order when it's received, so that's how we'll open them.
This is from First State Tire Recycling out of Tana, Minnesota, Estonia. Okay. $370 per ton. First State Tire Recycling is $370 per ton of waste tires. And this is New Deal Tire Company of Groton, South Dakota. And that's $180 per ton of waste tires. And this is Liberty Tire Recycling of Savage, Minnesota. Does everybody want to copy this?
I'm surprised we didn't get copies of all of them. No, you do.
Usually they put enough in, but some don't. That one did.
Does everybody want a copy of it?
I don't need one.
Didn't have the others, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, compare it anyway.
$225 per ton of waste tires. This one is SRSS Incorporated.
Standard
Rock
Sanitation. What's their actual address?
$135 per ton of waste tires.
I just asked that I get a little time to review those and then make a recommendation, and later on in the meeting I'll have you guys hold on just to ensure that all the specifications are met and everything.
Later this meeting?
Yep, later this meeting.
Are you doing that with the other one? Or no, the other one's
table
the
next.
Next
meeting, yep.
You all look at everything?
Yes, please.
We're going to table that until Ryan comes back with his recommendation.
Our involuntary mental health folks, and wanted to keep track of them. They give you an idea how many of them are actually seen. K-17A1 was the first one we had this year. Not a resident of Walworth County, and it was an involuntary mental health code that was brought to Mobridge Regional Hospital. Mobridge Regional Hospital, because of how they're rated, they cannot deny and turn anybody away. And this one, Indian Health Services will be billed. There could still be some discrepancy about it. Usually there's a little contention. You've got to do a little proof. But that one's in the works, 17-1B. The address given by this individual is another county. Again, the individual is eligible or is enrolled for Indian Health Services, and it is an option. I've been trying to K-17-1C. This address was given. The address was given by this individual as a county, and again, eligible for Indian Health Services. It was just a one day, so the cost is $699.50 a day, and they can only charge us for 2 days. If they choose not after 3 days to move that individual down to a state facility, then the cost is on them. So these would be the amounts that would be Medicaid rate. I've been trying hard to, one more. 17-1D, another individual is eligible for Indian Health Services. The cost at this time has not been determined. I'm waiting for a call back from Denise Young because there were some extenuating circumstances that I wanted to double check. It looks like we will be paying for the medical assessment that an individual is required to have before a hospital will accept them into their program. They have to, to make it layman's terms, when I look at it, I call it, it's like having a physical to make sure that they're healthy. Because a state facility or a mental health or a detox center is not qualified, and they don't have the nursing staff for medical emergencies. Say I was having an appendicitis attack, they would have to transport me out of medical facility that handles that. That's the reason why the visits of the doctors there are not there for that particular reason. I've been trying to, going to do a better job for you keeping track just to show you how many mental health cases within voluntary hope that we do get to the Norwich Regional Hospital. And Jamie and I have been working with Josh Sherholt on making sure we get those commitment papers right away so we can determine the residency and then the fact of trying to get some of that money back that's coming out of Josh's budget for transportation, our mental health budget for their court-appointed attorneys or anything like that. So we're busy working on that. It's a slow process. This is kind of like the mills grind a little slow. And as you can see, we're still fighting cases from way back, but that's usually how it goes. I do have some good news. 16810 is an old case. It's finally been determined. The attorney for Avira is now offering a settlement with the individual. The money saved would be $5,958.25. This is one that we ended up going as far as the deposition and had the ability to prove the individual was not a resident of this county or of this state. So, yay, we won. I have two funerals. At this time, 1781 is the first one that we have received in this year. I'm determining the county of residency. I'm working with the funeral director, I believe, in Burlington, South Dakota. This happens to be one of those cases where he was brought into the Golden Living Center, but just because you are in the Mulbridge Golden Living Center does not mean I'm trying to figure out where his residency actually was. And it's starting to look like it was Pollock to the VA, the VA to the deal, which would make Campbell County the county of residency. So we're working on trying to get that, Mr. Price knows that, so he's working with me. 17B1, this individual is a resident of Walworth County, does qualify for help. My suggestion would be to approve this individual, and of course the cost county to Walworth County is $2,500. But before I came up here, I did receive a call from Eric Schley that the individual's sibling had found out there was $600 in an account there. So I don't know if you want to take that into consideration and deduct that from the $2,500. But the individual definitely meets all the criteria for having some help.
So the motion would be then, I would recommend that be $600 that from the account. That's another response.
Thank you.
$1,900.
Yes,
that is correct. Can I have a motion to that effect? Pay the $1,900. You made that check? Second? Okay. Scott, second. Words are, you have somebody in here to take notes. Okay.
And Brenda, these are all like the mental health. Have we had more in 17, or are these just the ones? Or just
these
since
are
you started
just,
tracking?
Just the ones that I have papers and stuff on, and I believe there are a few possibly more out there. But I'm trying to work with Mulbridge Regional Hospital with Josh and Sherholt as well, just to figure out, you know, how, where. What we can do to keep the cost down for all parties concerned. We learned at the last convention, was it spring that we went, that I went to?
You went to, yes.
That, you know, there's some new ways that they're trying to get some of that money back from other counties.
Motion that has been made by Jim on the funeral cost of 17B1 of $1,900. second by Scott. Alyssa? Okay. Any other discussion on that? All those in favor say aye.
Aye. And also just a follow-up is this, the we've just been getting a lot of involuntary mental health holds from out of county. And so we initially started to look at the whether the hospital can refuse, which they can't, when they're coming from out of county. And then how do we keep from us being stuck with all the cost? Because technically, if I live in another county and I'm put in a mental health hold, I think our sheriff's office has been stuck with the transportation, is that right, Brenda, to Human Services Center or to Worthmore Addiction or some other mental health institution, which we need to get away from doing that. That's not our responsibility, it's just kind of fallen on us, but we're trying to track these a little bit better so we don't end up using deputy time, transportation, you know, assets, and keeping that cost down to the sheriff's department and to the county, because we've just seen a huge influx of mental health holds from out of county. The in-county ones we still have, and those are partially our responsibility depending upon the qualifications and stuff, but we just wanted to, because I know it had been mentioned earlier, why we get stuck with all these, so we're going to start tracking this, keep you better informed of what's going on and what we're trying to do to keep from having that cost be Walworth County's. So Brenda, I'll just keeping you updated on how many, because we have had a huge influx in the first 5 months of this year in mental health holds from out of county. Because we are basically, Mobridge Regional is the only area facility that's capable of taking residents in. Almost every county that borders us is going to use Mobridge Regional, except for maybe Potter County, and they may go to Pierre. So.
The dumping station.
Pardon?
The dumping station.
Well, a lot of the other hospitals don't want to do the committal fee. That's why they send them by ambulance to Mobridge or the unfortunate thing is we don't have anything near our county, a place where we can properly hold people, because what happens is a lot of them end up in the jail, or a lot of them end up going to a barrier, or once they get there, it's a matter of it's a detox issue or a drug addiction issue, and they can't hold them. And so a lot of those people,
help
or
be
held in a jail and putting
our
jails at risk too as well.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you,
Brenda.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Go to 20 discussion regarding courthouse grounds.
Well, I think I know what some of that is that Becky's talking about. I don't think the sprinkler system has been on. Is there a reason, do you think, why we don't run our sprinkler system? I mean, it's...
Jim Larson, he was in charge of it. Now, he sold that out, but I know it was working.
What do you guys want to do? I mean,
well,
I know it's what Becky wants. We were discussing it.
Well, I think we should have the sprinkler system on.
No, I would think so.
It is beyond dry, and the weeds are taking
over. Yeah, I saw you mowing on Sunday. That's even the ball game. It's,
there's nothing there.
Yeah, it's all pretty much weeds and dead grass, or dormant grass, isn't it? Because I know when you were mowing, it was just a giant dust.
Yeah. Did you say we haven't used it for years?
No, it hasn't been on. Becky might know how long. How long do you think it's been since the sprinkler's been on, Becky?
Somebody grab Leah.
The one thing too, and it's kind of a little bit off task, but with our government buildings, we should be the ones setting the example, especially when I'm out going after people for nuisance properties and things like that. We should be the ones that are setting the example of how especially our public buildings should look in their grounds and stuff. So, and that's just a personal view of mine, because it makes my job a little harder.
Okay. Courthouse grounds. what about the sprinkler system?
Sprinkler system, I'm not that familiar with. I don't know what's going on with the sprinkler system. I did have Kurt come in and kind of show me how to run it, but it's still actually winterized. It hasn't unwinterized yet, so.
Do you know when the last time it was actually ran?
No, it hasn't been in the last 2 years.
No, that's not true. It has been.
Yeah.
Yeah, last year, it wasn't, yeah, and he came in winterized. I talked to him when he did, but I thought he'd open it up again. But I do know that last year, a couple times, I was walking home at like 2 in the morning.
Really?
That it was running sometime in the morning.
It must have ran real often, I mean.
Not
was,
often at all.
No, but I mean, cause even last year, I seen the grass was pretty dead.
Yeah, but I just know that at least one time last year, two times, I mean, I do know that it was on.
Would you maybe want to contact him and see if he can come over here? Or?
It's like Dave said, it's who's the other guy that took body from?
Contact the guy that took that body from.
Is there a timer on it or anything? Or?
Yeah,
oh,
yeah.
Okay.
It's
so
it's one of those rain bird deals, and there's, you know, it's got to work.
When he comes, maybe have him come and pick me, because there's one out there that I have some questions about.
Oh, okay.
Possibly is a cluster, maybe.
And I guess my other question, too, is, I don't know, truthfully, what are we going to do with some of these trees out here? I mean, there is branches, I mean, that are up there in the trees that are broke off. And,
we really should have somebody come and just clean the whole works.
Unless you drove around and see them, but I mean, there's...
With the parking lot, there's some pretty good hangers.
There's tons of trees that are just hanging around and they're all busted off with branches.
And I think one fell on one of our old patrol cars that was last year or something after a windstorm.
Does Tony still do that?
Yeah, he does, yeah.
I can find out one that you can contact somebody.
I would think we need to trim it up.
We need to
look right out there and see dead branches and them trees.
It needs to be cleaned up.
It needs
does
to be cleaned
Does Tony have the equipment to do that?
Well, he does. It's just
time.
Yeah,
how much time should we give it?
It would hurt. Call him first.
Yeah, we can contact him and see when he's going to be available.
We
did have Brandon. Mr. Carlson came through and he trimmed some stuff down. And it.
There's two of them in Mobile Shoe?
Yeah.
Who's the other one?
Bubba. I think his last one. He does it now too.
All the low reaching ones we can go, but there's a lot more high.
Yeah, there's.
Trimmed off before they. Widowmaker, somebody.
Okay, do you want to contact Tony? I think he can get a hold of me if he can. Do I can get a hold of the guys in Mobile?
You want me to? Or?
On Tony?
Yeah.
Do Tony, and then if he can't do it, then I'll get a hold of the guys in Mobile.
Okay, who's going to determine what do you all want trimmed up on trees? Is stuff a lot of the dead stuff? Is that what you want to do? Or?
I'd say anything that's dead, let's trim it up, but do it in such a way as to
make it to look nice.
Yeah, if we can, and not kill the entire tree. But
okay.
You may want to set a limit on the cost, too, that we're going to expand.
Okay, I'll talk to Tony then.
Okay.
I'll talk to him and then. Yeah. And then I'll tell you guys nothing.
It's going to be put my chainsaw on it, it would be just fine. Also, talk about the signposts. We need to get signposts, put the signs up. We decided to go on 8-foot regular signposts. Makes sense. I can get them for $50 a piece that I can find online. I don't know if there's anywhere we can get them cheaper. Maybe actually go for someone local. I don't know anybody for sure.
Yeah,
so I'd like to put those up.
What's the signpost for?
To put up our authorized parkers only kind of deal. Because we put them on the small ones, which is fine until we get some snow and stuff, and then the cars are there and you can't really see them, so that is a waste. But
you have posts, any?
I have posts.
Post bar would probably work too. That gets a little spiky.
I thought you should be putting up.
It's durable. Yeah, maybe it'll last 1 year.
Well, we can discuss about that.
Putting up what?
Calspar. The square metal.
Oh yeah, I thought that's what we were talking about.
The flat sided ones.
The green
cheap ones. As long as they got flat size on. The other thing is car stops. We need to replace these car stops. Jensen said they can put new ones in. take the old ones out for kind of a limited price, but I think rubberized would be better. You talked about some. I found some online that I can get and get plastic ones for $40 with hardware, or rubber ones for $42 with hardware.
I found some for 17.
Did you? I'll talk with Penny.
Surplus has them for 15 piece on it here on 2.
Okay, this is what I found online.
So,
but I'd like to.
Yeah.
Have
I just saw that yesterday, so I thought since we're talking about that.
Please, so we can discuss that, because I'd like to have all uniform yellow ones, make them look pretty.
Okay, why don't you guys take care of that?
I don't know what the. Who's supposed to, we spray the sidewalks out here? I mean, that's, who does that? I mean,
no one that I know has ever done it, actually.
What do you do out there then if you don't spray them cracks? I'm talking about spray the cracks.
Yeah, no, I know what you're talking about. I actually sprayed them with vinegar last year and killed some along the front part of the deal.
I spoke with Shannon about it, and she said that she can do some spraying out here as long as it's not near any trees, because she doesn't want to take the chance. Killing a tree. So if it's the sidewalks, then I think that would be fine.
I just think it would look nicer. I mean, I got one other thing. We just thought you've probably seen it out here at that handicap parking sign. We took that. I took it. I'll fix that. It's broke off down in there.
Yeah.
But I'll get that fixed.
Great.
And I'll put it back up.
Perfect.
So
that one.
Anything else?
Did you want to address that? Coming down, or is that just
going to be okay, thanks.
Shannon was 10 minutes, so she
should
be here. I think she's here.
Is she
here? Yeah, she's here.
Good morning.
Good morning. We got a contract or whatever from the Department of Ag. In 2006, they requested a team when the railroad had that fire. Kurt Rostrom requested a team from the Department of Ag. And so with a big fire in February of 17 in Kansas, Oklahoma, Texas, they provided us with a contract. It's at no cost to us or whatever. It's just if we need some help, they would help, I guess. And we just need a point of contact. And I had talked to Kurt Rostrom. He would be a point of contact if we're interested in solar. So that's nothing to do with the airplane or whatever, it's just an extra resource that we need.
Basically, what they would like is the county to pass a resolution designating specific people to be the contacts for this. And it's for major wildfires.
And it would take place of July 1st of this year, and then it would just renew itself unless either party would want out. Just fire support from the Department of Ag.
Bring crews, or bring supervisor people, or?
By the way, it sounds like they would just provide help with kind of whatever we needed. They would bring a crew. I know there was an IMAT, said something about an IMAT team in here too, so.
I think this is just basically covering huge fires.
Yeah, nothing.
Which, the way it's looking, could be possible. But it's to designate someone, so we're kind of wondering who you would like designated as contact. And did you say Kurt was willing?
Mm-hmm.
Are you going to draft up the resolution then, and we'll approve it next meeting?
After you guys inform us of who.
Yeah.
Well, for
Kurt and Shannon, that's fine.
Roster.
Do you want both those people?
Hmm?
Do you want both those people, Kurt Rostrom and
Sharon?
Okay. Do we need a motion to have a resolution on that?
No, we'll wait for the resolution.
Okay.
That'll
you
be at next
that.
Meeting. You'll have to vote on that, but
okay.
Not on appointing the contacts.
And I can give you the rest of the contract, and you guys can look over if there's any more questions or whatever. We can address that at the next meeting. But.
Okay.
Kurt is still fire chief for Shelby, isn't he?
Yes. And so, actually, in this agreement or whatever, you would consider the county rural fire coordinator is how they worded it in here as a point of contact.
Okay.
We're just trying to figure out that would fit in. When you go out on a fire, you have your designated one that starts off, gets too big, it goes to the state. So would this fall under the state level then?
Yes, by the way, it reads yes.
We'll get you copies of it. You can move it before the resolution ends up getting passed. So if you want to make any changes to the context.
That would be good, because I'm just trying to figure out when we go out on fires, you know, there's a progression level in there, pass it on. Are we passing it on to somebody outside of that chain of command? Is that what they're, are they trying to get it, to move it outside of?
No, I think that there's coming help, because in here it says the state agrees to provide fireland, rangeland fire suppression assistance at the request of the board of commissioners or the designated person. So I think they would just come and help support whatever you need.
Okay. I've got the email with all the information. I'll forward it to you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And I can forward it to all of you.
Yeah. But they would just like to know by July 1st if we're going to sign the contract.
Okay.
I will get the paperwork around. If you guys have any questions, we can discuss it at another time. So.
Okay, we'll go to the discussion on the burn ban now.
I know Kurt requested putting it on too, and I think it's a good idea.
I'll make a motion to effect the burn ban immediately.
Second. A motion is made and second to have the burn ban started immediately. Any discussion on that? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Aye.
Alrighty. Let's see what else we have.
I got a question.
Yeah.
When do you consider the county a disaster because of what's going on? Somebody asked me that. I got a call this morning.
I have no clue on the answer to that.
I didn't, so I thought I'd bring it up.
Sully County, I think, is in the process of declaring a disaster at this time. As they have requested whether us surrounding counties had done that. We have not. And so that's just what I told her. But if you'd like, I can look into that before next meeting.
Probably a good idea, I guess.
So if we have a little bit of time, would you like to say anything?
Yeah. Yeah, Dave. I'd just like to thank you guys for everything. For the flowers, plants. It's hard, but I'm okay. This is a sentimental place. You guys know what, you know what you've done. I mean, Sue is a good employee. The people of Warwick County always supported her in an election. She's come to know a lot of people. And I found out, I didn't realize how many people she knew through her work through the state. It's humbling. I appreciate it.
She is a good employee of us, so we really appreciate it.
Yeah, she'll be missed by the family and a lot of people. I just wanted to thank you.
Sorry for your loss.
Yep. I know you are. Thank you.
Thanks for stopping.
Thanks, Rick.
Thanks, Rick.
Thanks, Rick.
Okay. Should we go into the executive session?
Sure.
We'll have an executive session. Can I have a motion to go into the executive session?
And it's a legal matter.
Yeah, it's a legal matter. Second? Okay. We're coming out of the executive session, and the matter that we dealt with was a legal matter, and it has been turned over to the state's insurance alliance already because it affects more than just our county. So it's all taken care of. Okay. Take a 5-minute recess until 11 o'clock when we call travel time. Okay, now we're going to have a conference call with Campbell County. Is anybody there?
From Walworth, we're ready for the conference call.
Okay, I will let Lisa know. Hold
Thank
on.
You.
Hello.
Hey, Lisa, we have our board here.
Okay, just a second. Let me get my phone set up over here, and I will put you on speaker. Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
That's what we agreed on too, is to hire one full-time and split with you guys. It sounds like we would have a better benefits package. We don't know what the cost of that would be yet until we hire somebody because it's age-related. But our position is we feel that we need a full-time 4-H advisor to split the duties with you guys and benefit both counties.
That's kind of how we're feeling ourselves down here. So I think the next step would be to kind of figure out how you want to send the advertiser for the position or what your guys' thoughts on that. I know there's a couple of different options to doing it, according to what Donna had last week.
Just put it out and start advertising for a full-time position for both counties would be my suggestion.
You're not talking about 4 years to be that. It's not mandatory to have a 4-year degree, is it? So that's an option. And are we talking about doing something where we're kind of doing it on our own and not even working with Brookings anymore? Much? That's kind of our thought. Sorry, like they'd love to do with Brookings and turn it off the car.
Scott, I thought that this is Brenda DeToy speaking here. I thought that Donna had said one of the options was is to prefer a 4-year degree, but will accept somebody with not a degree. Just because they have a degree would not mean that they would be connected to SDSU at all, because they would never be SDSU's employee. They would always be the county's employee.
Okay. We thought two members had a 4-year degree, but was the option if it doesn't, it's not mandatory to have a 4-year degree.
Right.
Why don't we just advertise both ways, say 4-year degree preferable but not mandatory?
Then we're gonna advertise number one is not Drew Brooks, correct?
Yeah.
Correct.
That's what I was talking about. That way,
you go
through Brooks, it's
going to
take a lot longer to get individual in here.
So my suggestion would be to go ahead and advertise it, put it out as 4-year degree preferable but not mandatory, and it'll be between Campbell and Walworth County.
I have a suggestion. Maybe Brenda DeToy again here. You get the 4-H advisory board together from both counties. You sit down and you get that notice that you're going to put in the paper for that you're looking for an employee, so that both counties have input and that it's okay with both. And then we just swoosh it out to the papers and decide where we want to go with that.
I think. What do you guys think? I think what they're I think we'd be fine with that, and we could say one trip and get the papers in. Well, you know what, that's my thought is, like you said, four-year degrees, not mandatory, advertise like that, and advertise until position filled. Yeah, we could do that. I don't know if we need to get together until we start getting some applicants, and we can get this thing rolling a little faster, unless you guys feel we need to get together.
I don't think we need to get together. Do you want to draft up the application deal, or do you want us to?
Becky?
Can I make a suggestion that maybe, considering the fact Brenda knows more about all of this than anybody, that maybe she draft something up and then just get it to one of you to approve if you would be interested in that, Brenda?
That would be fine, or send it to both auditors to look as you guys put notices like that in the paper to make sure it's going to cover all the requirements.
Yeah. As long as we have the same copy, so we put in the paper that's all on the same as both papers, I think that sounds good. Yeah. I don't know if Brenda wants to write something up.
Okay.
Sure,
okay.
That'd be fine.
Okay, sounds good. Anything else?
Not right now.
We'll draft it up and we'll get a copy to you.
Just a minute.
Can we do that? So I think you, what do you guys think? What is your weight for your package? So we kind of have an idea what do you think for weight.
Right now I make $15.19 an hour. My health insurance and my life insurance, but that'll change once you start in July 1st, because we have dental and vision and a better health insurance policy that's being paid, correct?
I do believe you should advertise it as wage depends on experience and go from there.
Especially if you don't know if you're going to afford to treat the individual or not.
Right.
The way Lisa and I had talked, it sounds like they would be a Walworth County employee and you guys would just provide half of the cost to Walworth County.
In fact, we'd pay you, we'd have to pay you guys.
Yes.
I think we're all on the same page as you guys. I think as long as we get something written up and sent down to the basement, have it looked at, then we get the paper. So we try on board as soon as we can.
Sounds good.
Sounds very good.
Then we'll get some applicants together, dogs together, then we can set up interviews at that point, or Beth or Brenda or what?
Yeah.
Once we get the applicants, Brenda will go through them and we'll set up a time to both meet and then we can go through them.
Would you like a deadline on this?
Well, not to put still position filled. Then whenever we get between the three, two, three applicants, we can. I mean, that's how you want to do it. That's why I thought we'd go until position filled.
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. And we'll just put wage depends on experience, and then after seeing your applicants, then you can probably decide on that.
Yeah, we agree with that.
Okay. Anything else?
I don't think so. Do you have any? We're good here.
So okay. We should just have the applicants in the advertisement sent to Brenda?
I mean, well, we can do that, yeah. I'm there on one spot.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, well, thank you guys.
Applicants, or you get one applicant, how long do you wait? Do you wait 3 months? Or?
Well, I suppose you wait until you find someone that you think is a very good applicant and just stop advertising.
You see that a lot of times.
I don't have a clue.
If you get somebody in there, the very first one you think that's a good applicant, then, yeah.
Okay.
That's what we should probably make sure Brenda.
Brenda?
As long as she knows that, yeah, because you're going to probably get them turned into you.
No, I'm going to have them sent directly to Brenda.
Okay.
She's going to know if they would be a good
We have a question. How long are you going to have it open? Do you think there will be applicants? Or?
You know, I think there's going to be some applicants. I really think there were. I know of two that are interested. I've had somebody else call me on the phone. I have one in my office right now because they wouldn't take no for an answer. So I said, fill it out. Give it back to me.
Okay. Normally, though, we should advertise for
30 days, isn't it?
Yeah.
2 weeks at least. 2 week minimum.
Okay. But typically at the courthouse, it's 30 days, though. Don't you usually give it a little bit longer?
Yeah, I guess it depends on the position.
How about if you go, you advertise it twice, and then unofficially close it the week after the second advertising?
Sounds good.
Sounds great.
How's that?
Okay.
And then if it needs to be reevaluated, come back and say, all right, we haven't found, or you've got three, or whatever.
Okay.
All right. Okay.
All right.
Okay. We're back on track with the discussion regarding the new jail. Dean Marski, Red. Dean? You guys want to come in? And what is your name?
Brad, huh?
And who are you with?
I'm with the National Institute of Corrections.
Okay.
H-O-M-B-E.
Oh, okay.
All
right. Just give us a couple minutes here, guys, so we get this set up. And show you. We're doing that. Pass those around.
Okay.
In a corner or something. We'll get one in front of the camera here, but.
What order do you want to be in here? That one's over there. That first one.
This
second one.
Is this yet? Well.
Two.
here.
Right. Steve Marsky with HKD Architects. Scott Sickett also with HKD Architects. We've been working the last couple of months, really the last 5 years, with the Walworth County Commissioners and really the working with both Jim and David, the committee, the Dale committee, and we kind of did a summary of where we're at to get to the commission. We're looking at, and there's really not a range under the board, but we'll start out with what are we looking at for a project, which is a, we'll talk about to get to that, but what we had was the 54-bed adult jail, 16-bed JVC, and sheriff's office. Our estimated cost at this time is $7,800,000. The existing site, and these are just kind of questions we've answered at over the time. They asked, what would be happening with the old site? We looked at a parking lot here. That doesn't necessarily have to be that, but we're looking at that. The benefits of the Walworth County, the increased ability to house other county, federal, and BIAMNs. We already have that, but it would continue or possibly increase. Decrease public safety, decrease liability risk, which we talked to from the very beginning with the old jail, and the tax dollars came in on. One of the questions the public has is, and this is, we did this for Fulton too. You know, what is better quarters for the prisoners? It's really not better quarters for the prisoners. I mean, you're in jail, let's face it. There's, Keith Fernandez, I guess, is one of the examples that it wasn't a good situation for him. We are providing a safer work environment for the officers and the liability protection for the county. That's what the basis is of this. And what happens if the old jail gets shut down and then say, we have to surround, inmates in surrounding county, space available. And we really checked on this, anywhere between $65 and $90 a day, plus transportation cost, bib cost, officer times, and we have a lot of this medical cost thing that we got from Josh. And basically just a comment from Jim Rollenhorst that finished there with the saying that when he was here at the last meeting that we need to address the jail. And then we looked at basically the operate the jail as it is. These I got from Becky as far as the operating cost, $852,000. That was for 2016. And that included an $83,000, which you did for some maintenance of the existing jail. Out of county income, which is a combination of both Becky's and Justin's stuff, was $605. So the net cost to the county is $147. The jail is grandfathered in. We all know that. But there's a liability risk to the county, and there's also a limit to the future of the out-of-county income as far as people coming in. Operating jail at Walworth County only, which is really no need, but it really takes out, as it goes, it would take that out-of-county income. You have the people there. You have the, 4,132 inmate days now with Walworth County, so you would end up with a majority of, I would say Josh and Justin, but you'd end up with a majority of the expenses you have. You'd have less meals, probably less medical expenses because if you just went to the Walworth County, that was an option we talked about, but you still have the risk to the county and the liability and increased costs over time. Really, we've seen the costs come up, I guess, from Becky showing. Oh, okay, well, I did something wrong here. He just pointed this out. I had a number wrong. Okay, if we go to the new facility, operating expenses, same out-of-county income, the net, a new jail, finance costs. I just took option A as we go to, which would be the opt-out option. I just took one of them. And to me, we'll look at that, there's two options. Revised county, new jail included, and then there would be a net savings to the county of the 187. Those are numbers that you can move them whatever way you want. There'd be no additional impact in the county by the county, possible increase of out-of-county inmates, reduced liability risk for the county, safer work environment for the officers and staff, and reduce the county increases for the jail. The reality of, in this, whether I put in here, like Josh said, we're 85. I must have, I thought I had that 95, but I don't know if that number works out or not. I assume that 41, 68 times 85 still equals that number, but someone check that. Josh, we're $95 today, so that's just, so it'd be more of a savings, the actual cost of Walworth County unit.
$395 or $396.
Which would be for $95 a day, right? Yeah, so the number's right there, it's the day, or the per day thing. Okay, so now we really get them adjusted. This is a financial option. If the county decided to go this direction of a new jail, you know, and that would be, we know that we're not committing that nothing is just saying the county has to do this, but saying that the county committed a $2 million commitment to Walworth County. Yeah, he just told me.
Okay.
So we got that. This is Toby Morris with the bonding. He said the opt-out levy, this is what they did in Fulton. And this the annual tax increase would be as 5.8 over 20 years, 3.75. Annual levy would be $417,380. Which is about 57 cents per thousand. This requires a 60% approval by the public, but it does not require that it be levied. Now, what we talked about, if the county continues to operate as it is, and you have monies coming in, you really aren't. This is only if something happens and they change something nationally that can't even put people in prison or in jail anymore. But if you stay operating as you are, you should not have to tax the county anymore, but it has to be there, it has to be done. That's where the USDA option, we talked to Tim Potts, he's a regional director, it's a general obligation bond, same situation as Toby Morris. It's, you know, the terms are 20, 25, 30, 35, but we did apples for apples, everything's 20 years. Interest rate at 3.375, annual levy of $390,500. Requires a 60% vote, but this does require that you levy the tax, which is crazy, but they say you have to do that, which would then, my understanding, impact the county. You can reduce the mill levy, but then that's like, in some respects, cutting your own throat. So if you know that, so then you can't raise it back up again if once the jail is paid for. But that's the downside with USDA. And then a third option we looked at was public safety facility services, and it's PISC, which is a tax exempt financing. They do bonds, or they do investments from people's retirement and those type of things. And this is the same amount. Their terms are 10, 20, and 30 year. Interest rate is 3.6, but their annual payment, now that includes some of their costs, is $464,436. And that's requires a vote by the commission, but it's only a majority vote. It does not go to, does not need to go to a vote of public, and we can talk to Jamie when I'm done here about that. And then at the end of that 20 years, or any time that you choose it to, if you choose to pay it off, the county can buy it, the building for $1, or if you want, they can keep operating it after that for the same amount of money. And basically, what I did a summary of that over, like, people have talked about, well, what do we actually pay for this over 20 years? Well, Doherty and Company is $8,347,000, USDA is $7,990,000, and the DFIC is $9,288,000. Basically, they get their money back out of it, so a majority of it. So that's what the, and that's basically what we've done for a summary of, we haven't addressed things that you've talked about, you get other counties involved, that's all something that can be decided. But the question is, and to the commission is, do you pursue, keep the jail as it is, keep operating as it is, the Walworth County, or build a new one? So that's what we've kind of developed over the last several months. Jamie, I ask you for, if you have any issues with the, what we kind of put there. So.
No, I think you're pretty much right on with the process on ways of dealing with funding.
we've had these guys do this, and Jim and I have been over there a number of times, and we've gone over this kind of stuff. And we have three options: paying this off, and if we do the first two, then that would put us back a year or more. And if we did it with the public safety, then we could get started on this project right away. And the one thing that's nice about them is that they would contact HKG and do all of that kind of stuff, and we wouldn't have to have anything in that. It would be taken care of, and I think it would be a great opportunity for us to get going on this.
And the county does not make a payment until the day that you take possession of that building. So clearly, you move your prisoners from one building to the other, and that's when you start making a payment. The day and same day you have any funds on that.
And just the one thing that I want to make sure that we're all clear with is there's no intent to close the existing facility until we can move them into the new facility. Because I don't think is that correct, Josh?
That's it, Harry.
That we're not going to close down any portion of the current jail until there would be a new facility to put them in, so we wouldn't have any out-of-pocket costs for housing our own prisoners.
Correct.
What I like about that public safety facility is we do nothing. We accept a key. We don't have to hire a construction manager. We don't have to go through the bidding deal. We don't have to hire a general contractor. They do everything. Josh meets with HKG, and they work with them to build the kind of building that we want.
Just to correct you, Jim, on part of that, there will be a construction manager. That'll be part of the process.
There will be, but we don't hire them.
No.
They do.
Yeah, that's correct.
They hire a construction man.
But
assume
I just wanted
they
to
get
clarify
Kim
that.
Kim Stecker on. They do
the
all
soils,
that.
The soil, yeah, that's part of the soil testing.
They do all that. We don't.
They do everything that we kind of talked about the last time we had those guys here.
Correct.
And it would take a lot of problems out of our hands.
So basically, by the looks of this, the existing courthouse would still be the existing courthouse.
Oh yeah,
yes.
It would be connected to the courthouse.
Just out of curiosity, who's responsible for maintenance and upkeep on the building under that PFIC proposal during the 20 years that we're making payments to them?
On all the proposals, you would be operation maintenance.
Sure.
No, as far as now that is a we would and I've talked to them. They would come in and discuss that. But I mean, as far as with Toby Morris or any of those, that is a good question. As far as when you say operate, they have operation maintenance responsibility for some of the buildings, but
that's what I'm getting at.
Operation, two different things, right? You know, operation versus maintenance. I believe that they do have some responsibility for the maintenance, but the operation, I mean, you're providing the people. They're not hiring your staff.
Right, because it's not.
I think it's different. Yeah, I think
the county would own the building until after that 20 years
right.
is up. So,
maintenance will have that. They will. I'm sure that they'll have that in their their budget for that maintenance. Because it'd be like anything you lease, you have some responsibility for the maintenance. So I think we'd have to define that.
I'm sure that's part of their increased costs as well. So.
Yeah. Yeah.
According to this plan, how many would you have per cell?
We have two people.
There's two.
Two per cell?
Yeah.
Can we reduce the pods?
The work release, though, Becky, there's four. The work release portion, there's four.
So this is just
okay.
Does it say in here what the square foot would be of that building?
Yeah, it was 18,000 on the other one. It's 18,000. It's what we originally, we haven't changed it for the general. I'm sorry, this is more of a presentation than, you know, 18,000 square feet on the main, 18.3 something. And I can get that for you if we have the original.
So it would be one main level and then partial upper?
Correct. And what we had talked with Trustfield about is having those cells, you know, and we're talking do some little cells that they would be able to expand up. Now, it comes down to the amount of, if you did it, if you add it on, which would be a good, well, you wouldn't do it unless you were needed more space if you were making money doing it, but you would then limit them to the day room. We can't, we're not increasing the size of the day room. So the day room is based on the plan we have here now, and it's not required that everybody have access to the day room all day long, so you have 2 hours for the lower level. If you did a second level, these are designed to add a second level on the male or the adult portion of it.
You have anything you want to say?
I think you're covering it all. And I'm just thinking of the meetings we had, and I think you've covered everything. You created a trying to answer. Our purpose was to come back to you with a summary of what we've done and what we have done. I would say the next logical step would be with promotions and
and the next step would be to ask these, like that public safety, to come to us with a proposal. Is that
what,
right?
The proposal, I would say they could come proposal and they come in and discuss that proposal with you. And I talk to them, I talk to everybody, obviously. And the next meeting, if this commission decides to go, makes a motion, the next meeting in 2 weeks, any whatever direction you decide to go, if that's the case, those people would be here.
If a person went with that, being we would not own this building for 20 years, can they make any decisions as far as not going with trust built or anything like that? Is that all going to be commissioner's decision?
Well, that's what they told us, that we'd have input, and that's the direction we've gone with the budget numbers that we have. But, I mean, there's always a... They would have that option, yes. I can't say for sure.
It would all be in the lease, as far as what they're going to deliver, you know, the plans, how many beds, all of that. I would assume we would enter into an agreement on.
Well, HKG will be the contractors on the designing.
Correct.
So they're doing
and they have worked with Trustbuilt.
Yeah.
They like worked with them before, so it's not like we're bringing in a group they don't know. And they asked me about contractors, which we talked to them about. Kybert's, the guy, you know, Matt Wiener, those guys who are doing the Falkland one, and Huff, and then there's Grave Construction, the three that we talked to them about. So they get proposals from them. But we haven't gone much beyond that, just to let them know this is what we got. You know, we shared a plan with them. Because really nobody's gone any farther than that because of the, you know, not wanting to move forward with it at this point.
Yes.
So what would it cost, do you know, for them to come and give a proposal?
I think it'd probably be time and air if you want to do that ahead of that, you know, decision.
Well, if they're giving a proposal to build a facility, wouldn't they pay for their own costs to come visit with us?
I'm saying if you say you want to come and present it, and you possibly don't sign something with them, they'd be reimbursed. That's all. I guess I didn't.
But I thought we were talking about maybe doing a motion before.
I know that, but I was kind of looking. I don't know what Melissa was saying. And she was saying if they come beforehand, if they come, if you make the motion go that direction, then it's part of the fee. So, but if you were guess I was trying to, you know, and she was,
if we asked them to come in before him.
Before deciding.
Yes.
Okay.
I've talked to a number of people in my area and on the Selby School Board, and they all advise to turnkey, let them take care of the construction and the construction manager and the ground crew and the bidding and all that.
Okay.
I would make a motion to ask the public safety facility to bring us a proposal.
So we wanted to enter into contract with PFIC for the design, construction, and tax exempt financing of the Wallacon Jail, and have HKG Architects will be the architect of record for this project. All costs will be incorporated into the final construction costs submitted by PFIC.
Is that your motion?
Yeah, make that motion.
Can I get a copy of that?
I have to clarify that.
There you go.
Yeah, my girls make me a copy of that.
So we should be very specific on these.
Yeah.
What our motions are and everything. Very specific.
It's going to be written the exact way you said it.
Yes.
My question is if we go with PFIC, we're going to have. You could have three members of this board deciding $9.288 million without putting it up to a
board of account. That's exactly right.
Well, we don't really, we have a motion on the table or not?
We have a motion on the floor by now.
Okay, let's have him rephrase what that motion is just so.
Let's wait for the paper.
Everyone is aware of what the motion is before we enter into a second and a discussion.
Holy cow.
It's that last paragraph.
The Lawler County Commission is in pursuing the construction of a 54-bed adult jail and 16-bed juvenile detention center and new sheriff office. The County Commission will enter into a development agreement with PFIC for the design, construction, and tax-exempt financing of the Walworth County Jail. HKG Architects will be the architect of record of this project. All costs will be incorporated into the financial construction cost submitted by PFIC. That's the motion.
Yep.
Can I have a second?
So the way you said it, it just sounded like they would come and give a proposal.
Yeah.
Then the full detailed explanation sounds like we would be already starting the contract.
Right.
Is that right?
I'm agreeing with Melissa.
Are we making a motion on having them come and just visit with us, or are we making a motion on going into contract with them to start the project?
To bring us a proposal.
That ain't how Dave made it sound.
This motion here is completely different than just requesting a proposal.
My guess.
Which one did you mean, the bottom?
Yeah, the bottom one.
Walworth County Commission is pursuing the construction of a 54-bed adult jail, 16-bed juvenile detention center, and new sheriff's offices. The County Commission will enter into a development agreement with PFIC for the design, construction, and tax-exempt financing of the Walworth County Jail. And then it goes on, HKG Architects will be the architect of record, and all costs to be incorporated into the final contract cost submitted to PFIC. So basically, my reading is that commission will enter into a development agreement, so some type of written agreement with PFIC for the design, construction, and financing.
So according to that, you are already making decision to spend $9.288 million.
Can I ask, I think with the way this is written, you're entering into an agreement to go with them.
Right.
What you want to see is you want to make sure you have the right to negotiate the terms of that and see that and approve that final contract.
You're not signing a contract with them. They have to give you a proposal, which then you have to sign. But you have to this is what I guess Melissa and you and I were talking about, and Becky saying that you'll need to come and see your proposal. You haven't signed anything, Kevin. You know, you're telling them that your intention is to do a project.
The way this, we're pursuing the construction. So
that, well, developmental agreement, I guess, and maybe that has to be clarified, but
that's what this is saying.
You still have to sign a contract with them.
The construction of this.
We still just have a motion on the floor.
It's a development agreement.
Discussion.
So it's a development agreement.
But we still don't have a second yet either. So we should probably have the motion. We'll need a second, and then we should get into the discussion where we can answer these questions so we can get clarification.
Do you think maybe we should have asked him if he would like to withdraw his motion for the moment and then make a new motion after some discussion?
That's up to you guys. That would probably be wrong. It sounds like to me that you want to discuss a lot of things before you entertain a motion, so.
We're just jumping right in.
Yep. So that's up to you folks to decide what you want to do, but I think if there's going to be a lot of pre-discussion, you should probably do some discussion ahead of time. So do you want to withdraw your motion initially?
Yeah,
for the moment. Okay.
So now you folks can discuss the questions that are flying around out there with regard to.
Yeah. I guess this is just blowing me away, because we were talking about maybe having contracts with people, and then all of a sudden just let's snap our fingers and let's build a new jail. Not even have a clue. I mean, you better inform me, Dave, you and Jim, because something's not making any sense here. It looks like this is all a cut and dried deal, and you're not even discussing anything else. You're just discussing a new jail. I'm talking.
Yes, I'm sorry.
Yep.
So, explain to us a little bit here. I'm pretty sure Kevin feels the same way. I'm not sure how Melissa is, but anybody that is watching this, if they don't think that basically what it is you're throwing this in our face and you're not even discussing anything else.
Well, what do you want to discuss?
That's the problem, Dave. You're not even looking then how this jail is even going to get paid for. You guys will sit there and say, well, $605,000. Tell me how this jail is going to get paid for then. Just because we have people coming in here to stay, you're not even talking about contracts from other counties or anything. Nothing.
As if you listen to them.
Oh, what do you think I do? Don't listen at all here?
What did they just say about the, this is the start of it. You can have contracts. How many counties have you contacted?
I have it right here in front of me. I wanted to ask you guys if it was all right what I proposed to the counties. What do you think I'm going to do, just snap my fingers and figure this out?
Kevin.
In my mind, it doesn't make any sense to jump straight into this and be able to just off on a whim have three people decide on $9.2 million worth of county stuff. Why don't we have public people come in here and give their views on it? We want to vote on it? Do we want to just have three people decide on this? That's all we need is a majority decision on this. If we go with this plan, what's wrong with entertaining possibilities of these other plans and putting it to a public vote to see what the public wants instead of three people out of this county? To me, it doesn't make any sense for three people to decide $9.288 million worth of stuff just because, oh, we can get it done quicker. You're going to have a lot of farmers that are going to be really upset over this deal. And when they don't start paying their taxes for 5 years, we'll see what happens then. Because you're slamming this down their throat.
We already had a public meeting. The majority of the people there, all but about two or three, were in favor of a new facility. And we postponed it a year or two since then, just because we want to stall.
this is the way to get a new facility for the county and have out-of-county income paid for it without charging the taxpayers of this county.
When we looked at this with the pods 2 years ago, at that time, if we would have gone with it, it were $10,000 at that time. Now they're $17,000. How long are we going to wait? Percentage goes up 10% a year on the cost. At what point do you think it's time to build?
And let's put it out to the public to have them vote on.
We just
turned down $344,000 a year because people didn't want it. Now we're going to make them pay for $9.2 million. Let them decide instead of three people on this board. That's my opinion.
I don't know that we turned down $300,000 on anything we've done in this board. We said ordinances, which is a total different subject than a jail. This is the way, and everyone I have talked to from the Selby School Board and the people in my area, this is the way to get a new jail paid for with no tax burden to the county or the citizens of our county, and they handle everything.
You might have talked to a handful of people. Maybe why don't you talk to the other handful of people?
I have talked to more than a handful. I've talked to more people than would fit in this courthouse.
It's amazing because hell, I just had one guy when I walked up the stairs this morning at 8:30. From your area. That I guarantee you.
Who was it?
I don't have to say a name. All I'm saying is you seen him walk right up with me. We were standing out there. You have to know him. I ain't going to say no name here. You know, you seen him.
I did not.
Let's all calm down, gentlemen.
I'm just saying, I mean, I don't know what handful everybody talks about, but this ain't just a little decision. You guys make it sound like it's just a little decision. Hey, let's just build a new jail. It's only $9.2 million. What the hell? I think Kevin's right. Why don't you should be talking to the public. You shouldn't be talking to us five people here. They should be included in on this whole thing.
Absolutely.
You're talking, hopefully this lasts more than 19 years that jail over there did. Hopefully this lasts for 20, 30 years, but, you know, gonna have to do this all over again.
Isn't part of the fee we paid HKG include public informational meetings?
Yeah.
Isn't that what we done upstairs a year or so ago or 2 years ago?
But now, well, and it was also $5 million then. There's been a lot of changes since then.
Just a couple things. A little off board from what I came here for, but just listening to your presentation. It's up to you guys, but I could do my spiel and you could postpone the motion decision on that. But just a couple questions for you on the motion that was posed. Are you saying that's final approval to go ahead and that's going to be the final cost, or is this just to develop the project and then later you can decide on construction?
Right. That's what I was saying. That this is start the process. This is not you signing the contract. This is a development. But you're right. It's that direction that you're seeing going, versus like the opt out option. It's a direction. That's what you're saying. This is not a final.
So at this point, you're designing further.
Yes.
But as an audience member, I didn't necessarily catch that either in the motion.
Right. That's
so maybe a reword. Because I'm.
Well, I think that. Take the motion.
You certainly got to have a more in-depth plan before.
Right. PFIC needs to come to this committee or commission and tell them what this is, and then they eventually would come with a proposal that would have to be signed by the or approved by this commission. We don't have a proposal from them. I can't say that you're accepting a proposal. I just did the background and said these are the options. But it is a direction versus public vote versus going to. No, this tax exempt. There's two different directions. Correct.
But I can certainly answer some questions on history of what other counties would do, have done throughout the nation, and what NIC recommends for processes. and may offer you for technical assistance further. I haven't even done the evaluation of the jail. I just got here this morning, and I'll do that today and tomorrow, but it may help the board, you know, understand kind of what they're getting into a little more. It's up to you guys.
Just out of curiosity, then, with the public meetings that we were supposed to be having included in the fee, where in this process with this motion and everything else would those fall?
Well, with the PFIC, there would not be public. And we have been, you know, obviously we've been spending time doing what we've done here. But I mean, we would have, if you decide decision to go to the opt out, then it would be public meetings. I mean, it's just two different
ways. So if we go with PFIC, then they're not going to be informed prior to.
Well, you can, aside you from can do them, you can do public meetings. I understand that it's not required for the to a vote. But, I mean, we don't have a problem doing public meetings at all. We just haven't, and that would be down the process, I guess, to let the public know. It would be your choice. So we're not saying that, it's just that it's a different option. Public meetings to inform the public about what was decided versus public meetings to do a vote. I mean, you've got two different directions with that.
But I think either way they should be informed.
Correct. I'm just saying that just how you present it.
Just the way, and I know it's not on the table anymore, but just the way, you know, the motion was worded, it does sound like it would be that we would start an agreement already, and so I think that's a little drastic for, you know, the wording of the motion, how it is. So I mean, I'd be interested in hearing about proposals, but not just something that's decided today.
I'm going to agree with Melissa. Anybody that watches that tape right there, if they don't think she thinks it, the gentleman back there thinks exactly how that was worded, is exactly what you just said. I bet you 95% of the people that watch that tape would think the same thing. The wording to me was like, we are, here we are, we're going.
It's your choice. Right now, we don't have anything. Commissioner Houck withdrew his motion. So right now, there is no motion or anything on the table. We're just discussing the jail situation. It's where we're at right now, is the way I'm looking at it. And until somebody makes another motion, we're still in the discussion phase on what is going to happen today or not going to happen today.
I think, Brad, you're here to go and look at the jail and provide more information to the board.
Yes.
So maybe that would be helpful for you guys as well.
Maybe we should have the gentleman explain. Could you just kind of tell
sure.
us what?
Sure. My name is Brad Hunt. So what the sheriff did is the National Institute of Corrections offers technical assistance free of charge to the counties. And they contracted me to come and do basically what they call a facilities and operations assessment. So what I'm starting to do this morning, and I'll do the rest of today, this evening, and tomorrow, is look at all the facility, the operations, policies, procedures, everything. So it's not just facility. Am I looking at, yeah, you need to build a new jail or it's out of date? I'm looking at everything. Recommendations for how the sheriff could operate the jail more efficiently or process recommendations. So that's what I'm going to do, and I don't want to prejudge until I have a chance to do that. Tomorrow when I'm done, I'm certainly going to have a debrief with the sheriff and anybody that's on the commissioner to welcome to sit in, so there won't be any surprises in the report when it comes. But then within probably 2 to 3 weeks, I'll get you a written report. So that's what I'm here to do. I wasn't necessarily aware that you had gone this extreme for plans before I got here today. So that's what I'm here to do. Any questions on or anything that you want me to look at or questions for me? Happy to answer those process questions on how other counties have done NIC services, whatever.
Just that's what I kind of want to clarify. You're here to provide an evaluation of how our jail functions and how we can approve, which is totally separate from this issue. That's what I wanted, because that's what I thought, but I just wanted to get...
I wasn't even aware of it.
Yeah, I just wanted to make sure that there was clarification that your duty is to see where we can improve as a jail, and what we're doing good, what we're doing
good
fair,
and
what we're doing inefficiently in order to run a more efficient jail. And that's your responsibility here, separate from the issue that's kind of being discussed right now. So.
I am assuming that all of you are going to want to visit with him after he's completed his... do you have an idea of what time you might be complete with this? Because it might be beneficial to call a special meeting.
If
because
if
they're
forum,
all going to be here...
If you're going to have more than... two members of this commission, you're going to have a special meeting, because then you would have a quorum and you'd be in violation of open meeting rules. So if more than two want to attend your debrief, you should probably call a special meeting for that time frame, so we're not in violation of open meeting rules.
Is that okay with you?
Tomorrow, you mean?
Yeah.
Whenever you're finished. Like, if you have an approximate idea, as long as it's at least 20 or 4 hours from now, we can get it going.
Yeah. 2 o'clock?
2 o'clock.
And there was time? 3 o'clock? 2 o'clock? 2 o'clock?
I'll get up. Okay, I'll get up.
Oh, I'm going
to be sure. What are we going to do? I'd like to do a
discussion.
Sure. Tell me that again.
Yeah.
After we...
We'd like to. I guess I'd like to come to the meeting too.
Okay.
I mean, it's open meeting.
It'll
so
be an open meeting,
yeah. We're in Falkton at the jail tomorrow, so we'll come from one jail to the other.
Okay. Then we'll let you know how things are going. Okay. Thank you guys for your presentation.
All right. We want to leave the board here for now.
Do you guys have specifics that you would like?
I think some of the commissioners can probably discuss with you offline on to see if you're covering specific things that they would probably like some feedback on, if that's all right.
Perfect.
I don't think we had to put anything on the record, and just up to the commission members to see if that's being covered, like say laundry costs. Are we being efficient on laundry costs or something like that, to make sure that that's he's going to include that in his the determination on whether we're doing it efficiently or not. And then, but then with regard to the other issue, do you want to put that on the next meeting, or what are we going to not put anything on, or I think that's another issue you need to address too.
Can we decide that tomorrow after we visit?
But you would put two issues then on for tomorrow, the jail issue and then the, I guess we could call it an audit. Is that a good way to put it? Or jail
assessment.
Inspection?
Assessment.
Or assessment? Okay. Put those two items on for the special meeting.
Okay.
And that will be it too? Tomorrow?
Scott, you need to talk briefly about the roof as well here. So.
We've got a pretty good handle on the re-roofing here. We'll be bringing to the next board meeting in 2 weeks. Will be advertised for bids for that. The only issue we have is drainage. Once we get it down the building, where do you want to go with it? And that was our question before. We're going to cut across. That's what the pipe was before. We did not. That's our. Would this county do that? You guys have people, or do we have to include civil?
You need to dig it in?
So, well, we can get it down the building and just where do we go this way? Because that's where it was before. Or do we go back, you know, to the, which would be the northeast? Is that the other option? Someone talk on
the county wouldn't have that ability, would they, Penny, to trench in and put in a water line or a runoff line? So basically, that would be included in the cost.
We don't want to drain it on the ground, right? Correct?
No.
I mean, it was in before. We're going to put the new pipe to the inside, come down, and we're going to channel it to, you know, a
a storm sewer.
You and I talked about that before.
But I guess in my mind, I'm looking at going, you know, you're two different, we got two different things going on right now. We got looking at a new jail and this roof here, but I mean, I'm pretty sure the new jail is over there.
Correct.
But I mean, and that's where we got to get to. With that pipe, what I'm saying is, I mean, what would you do? Go all the way out and go with it? Is what I'm getting at.
Well, right now it goes across.
What I'm saying, to get to the storm sewer.
Right.
Storm sewer is running out here.
Right.
East and west.
Well, the thing would be, that's what I was saying with that, because that was tied into the new jail. And we talked, Rick, you know, do we go that way? Or do we go back this way? Can we not go to the northeast and to
Conti? You're thinking of going...
Well, that would be the thing. So we can wait until we see what the jail here, too, what's going to happen or what your thoughts are, and just talk more about it. But that's the only, that's what, to this commission, I just want to get out there and say, we're good with the roofing and doing everything down. We just need to think about it, and when we come discuss it tomorrow, or whatever, to figure out how we want to do that, where we got to get to the storm sewer, because it's over there. So,
you know, I guess, to me, if I was doing it, I mean, I would say, well, I would still go that way. I would go that way so you can, if you would build a jail, you could tie that all back in over here and not disturb
this too. Yeah, you'd come out with the jail and go that way, yes.
Right, and then you could just tie that all together. I mean,
okay.
That's me, that's how I would do it.
Right, and that's what we're kind of thinking, but you know, at the same tying into the jail, but if you don't do the jail, then you can just go straight across. But maybe that is probably the correct way to look at it, as opposed to going, okay.
So, and then just for clarification, and so your question, I think, is that the commission sounds like they're in agreement that you want them to go straight that direction and then up the street, and then it would be as part of the construction cost that Walworth County would not be doing any of that. That was one of your other questions, right?
Right.
Like we would. So it would be part of the cost to do the roof would be to run the line out and then North Scott.
Right.
That would be the plan, to run it that direction. West and then north. In this, so. And that's what you wanted to know.
Yeah, I mean, that's where, I mean, to me, you'd have, if in the jail would happen, I mean, so that you can use that there too and not have it there.
And that's what your question was,
right.
Which way
we
you
don't have several in there to connect on. Yeah. So we'll have to, and you have,
Do you have somebody local that can do that? Could do lay that in, and we just bring it to the outside of the building and they hook on, and we avoid?
Yeah, but I mean, you'd have, it's got to be, well, there's all
sorts of people. Yeah, that portion would be under the bid limit. So.
Yeah.
So
there's all sorts of people that could do it.
Yeah, you could separately bid that portion if that's what you want to do. But I think your question was, in the big overall scheme, which way are you going to want to run the line and who's going to be responsible for it?
Right.
And if the county had the resources to do that,
right.
And the county does not. So,
right.
Does that put everybody on the same page now?
Yes, correct.
Okay. But truthfully, all in all, I would just as soon see it go that way. Me personally, you don't have the mess in the front yard, then you got sidewalks to deal with. And if you go out back here.
That's what we would do too, is assume that there was the other option to go back there. So. All right, that's great. We'll get there.
Thanks.
All right, thank you.
Okay.
Yeah, I think
okay. Okay. I need some verification on the second agenda item. The assessment on there, what you like it specifically to say, because are we possibly going to make a decision on which option to go with?
I think that's where you're at.
Because that would need to be pretty specifically written on the agenda.
Yeah, we should probably get it specifically. You should probably word it what you specifically want to address. I think she's right. So.
Because if we might possibly make a motion like the one that was proposed here, it really needs to be specific as an agenda item. We can't just say jail discussion. It should be a specific.
Then that would come back to Melissa's. When Melissa asked me if, say, you want them to come out and tell you, because you already talked to Toby, you know what his position. We've never talked to this. But if you're going to have them come, they're separate, and maybe after Brad's done, and say, tell us what you're going to do. That's what I was referencing, there would probably be some costs involved. We can talk to them before tonight, before tomorrow.
Or would it be best to just have his assessment on this agenda and any decisions to be made wait till the next meeting?
Something this commission
should do is wait till the next meeting. I mean, you already got one thing, him going to discuss everything with you.
Okay.
I think it should be put right there.
All right.
Let's get this out of the way for people.
We're doing the agenda right now. We have to get another 2 hours, so I want to know specifically.
So just going to have the one item.
Just the one item then tomorrow.
And then the other issue that was going to be on is going to be on the next meeting.
Okay.
Okay. Is anyone in agreement with that?
Just the one item.
So, okay. Clear as mud.
Mr. Keel?
Problem is the sheriff and Jamie. I don't appreciate Josh Bowles pushing into my apartment and assaulting me.
And when did this allegedly happen?
2nd of April.
Of what year?
2013. It was before Dwayne Moore got out of the office. And I called him the day after it happened. And he said, all I'm going to do is stop doing it. Well, if somebody else would have pushed their way through into an apartment and did what he did to me, they would have been sent in jail.
And were they investigating something?
No. I was telling them about something that happened that day.
Okay, and what was that?
I'm not going to discuss it because that was taken care of.
What was the problem that was taken care of?
I already told you, Jamie. I told you five times and you don't want to do nothing.
I am not going to prosecute Sheriff Bull for your allegation. That's correct.
And why not?
Because I don't think it rises to a crime.
It doesn't rise.
And I.
How would you
please let me finish, Mike. I told you before that I am not going to prosecute Don Connect or Sheriff Josh Bull for any type of illegal entry into your apartment.
Well, as far as I'm concerned, from what I learned from the governor's office, the county commissioners can do something about it. I don't have to go to you.
That if they want to make a decision and refer it to the Attorney General's office or the DCI, I think that's already been done, hasn't it, Sheriff Holt? Or not?
What's that?
Did Mike's complaint already get referred to the DCI before for investigation?
Yes, it did.
Okay, and when was that done?
When he made the complaint.
Okay, and back in 13. Okay.
And that was by a guy who was sitting in here. That was the sheriff at the time who should have done something, and it didn't get done.
Well, I guess, how are we supposed to, you're sitting here talking, I mean, why don't you tell us what it's even about? I mean, hell,
I was followed home from Fort Meade by VA cops, and every so often getting stopped, and they wouldn't do nothing. And when I wanted to complain about it, what I get is I get a drunk deputy sheriff showing up in my apartment thinking he knows everything.
And those are all just allegations.
Those aren't allegations, that's the damn truth.
And also, Mike, you were prosecuted by the United States for... Please, let me finish. For your incidents with regard to the Veterans Administration, is that right?
Well, here's what. That doesn't have nothing to do with this.
Basically, I think it does have a lot to do with it, because you're alleging that they were harassing you, but you were actually prosecuted for harassing them. Is that right?
No, I was not harassing them.
What were you prosecuted
for?
What were? If you don't want to answer the question, that's fine.
That's nothing to do with this.
Well, I think it does, yeah, because the whole thing starting back is
well,
and when you called me, and when you called me recently, it was because you wanted us to prosecute the Veterans Administration for calling you within the last 2 months. Is that right?
And that was, that's on paper.
Okay, and then Sheriff Bull came to, and Deputy Bentz came to investigate at your apartment, and that's when you had an altercation with Sheriff Bull. Is that right? You tried to make a citizen's arrest of him?
Well, guess what?
Well, I'm just
asking a question. I got a record of that too. But nobody in this county wants to listen to somebody who's been abused.
And then also, you...
You're the worst one of them, Jamie.
You can call me whatever you want, that's fine. It doesn't really matter to me what you think or what you want to say. But the point of the matter is now, when we asked you to cooperate with the investigation, you got into a physical altercation with Sheriff Bull at that last investigation. Is that right? And he walked out of the room?
He was asked to come over by himself, and he didn't do that.
But he came over with the deputy, and then...
And I have a right to talk to him by myself, not with somebody else there.
That's his choice.
Not when it comes to coming in my house.
Well, that's the position that the county is that they can send one or two officers. The other thing is when you called me and I asked you to give me the individual's number that called you, you didn't have that. Is that right?
I told you I had it on my phone.
Right,
I couldn't get it off of that minute.
But you didn't give it to me and you didn't give it to law enforcement, did you?
Yeah, I give it to law enforcement.
Was it given to you, Josh?
Yeah,
I saw the video when he was in your apartment, and basically it lasted about 15 seconds because then you got into a physical altercation trying to make a citizen's arrest on Sheriff Bull.
I'm going to put this down. I'm going to say it hard. And Mr. Huff, you know me good enough. I'm going to say it hard. And Scott, you know, was doing the same thing. I'll say it hard. Okay. I think the three of us are good enough friends. When I say, hey, I want to say it hard, I say it hard. This is my 180 days I'm giving you notice for what's been done to me by county employees. And you're still classified an employee, even though you've been elected into office.
You have your rights to do whatever you want, Mike.
Well, this is 180 days. Start.
Of what?
I sue Josh Bowles and Dwayne Moore for not doing it. And Dwayne, you were still in office when it happened, and I bitched to you about it, and you didn't do a damn thing, did you?
There wasn't enough there.
There was not enough there.
Not from what I had.
I told you that Don Connect was there.
Don Connect was acting on behalf of the city.
And he didn't tell you what was going on? And that Josh Bowles is the one that broke in, not the city?
Okay.
That's the way it sits.
All right. Enough's enough.
Let's enough go. Is enough. I've already got my attorney hired. He's already got...
Who's your attorney and we can...
It's going to court. There's no more talk.
Well, why don't you tell me who your attorney is so we can at least cooperate with him in providing him what
you will find out when you get the paperwork.
So as of right now, you don't have one?
I got one.
So why do you not want to tell me?
Because he asked me not to.
Okay. And then?
And that, from now on...
That's fine. You have your rights to do whatever you want, Mike.
So it's Josh.
We honestly don't care who you sue. You can sue whomever you want. That is your right. When your attorney provides us with paperwork, we will forward it to deal with it how we feel best. That's your right.
And they're not going to be talking to the judge before you get the paperwork.
There usually isn't.
Because I'm steaming hot.
I'm
the one that got busted up more because somebody couldn't keep their hands off me. That's the way I'm going to put it to you.
You have your rights to do whatever you want, Mike. That's okay.
Well, you've been asking for it. That's all I'm going to say.
That's fine.
Okay, go to order.
I'm saying one more thing. Don't laugh. Don't laugh.
About
this
what?
Ain't no laughing matter.
Okay, we're going to old business. We're done with you.
Hey, yeah. Before we go to old business, can we address that waste tire?
Okay, we'll do that.
I had a chance to look through all of the bids that were submitted based on the price that we came in at. Standing Rock coming in at $135 a ton, even with them disposing of the product on site. Our rate for that would be $20 a ton normally, so just in theory, you could add another $20 a ton to that to make the, all things equal, and that would bring it up to $155, and they'd still be the low bid. So I can't see any reason not to accept that proposal. Yep.
Make motion to accept Standing Rock's proposal for $135 a ton.
Second. Any discussion? Okay, no discussion. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Okay. Okay, now we'll go to old business. Anybody have any old business? Yeah.
Molstead guardrail should be put up next week. It's either going to be on Monday or Tuesday, probably on Tuesday. Got somebody coming out to dig the holes. I still got to get those railroad ties from you. They're bringing the guardrail in. So by next week, that guardrail should all be up. I still got your reflector tape to see if that'll stick or not. So
what's that?
See if it'll stick on there. Or,
yeah.
And we'll get some spray glue to put on there. And, if anybody wants to come out and help, I'll know for sure what day it's going to be. It's either going to be Monday or Tuesday. Probably going to be Tuesday, so Tuesday morning.
Okay, any other old business? Any new business?
Have you checked any more on that historic building grant or...
I haven't really looked. I mean, I know what it entails. I know what it costs and stuff. So it's just a decision on whether or not you guys are going to put that much money for it. That's the decision you got to make. If you want to put the $25,000, commit the $25,000 to rehab it, then so be it. Otherwise, do something else.
Okay. Okay, Jamie and Josh are like an executive session for a legal matter. I have a motion to that effect. Second?
Second.
Okay, we're going into executive session.
You guys like
it? I don't know who it was. I have no idea who it was.
You don't even know who it was?
No. I probably see him. I have no idea who it was.
Any new business?
Regarding executive sessions, I think when we want to put something on, the chairman should be notified. So I believe it's your responsibility to determine who sets in on the executive sessions. So I don't know if that has been our policy in the past. We've just got away from it. If not, I think it should be.
Well, it's not in there like that. It doesn't state it in there. In the little Bible there.
But you also have the state. Codified laws here that state things, and it states in here. And that's more important than our Robert's Rules of Order.
Oh, so then we can.
No, I'm saying, no, you can use that, but I'm saying that the law of the state of South Dakota oversees that.
Yeah, but I mean, anybody can call it an executive session here. I mean, if you want to.
But I have to know about it.
If you want to call it, tell you.
I would like to know about it so I have an idea of what it's going, what it's about.
Well, I don't know. I'm not speaking just because Dave's chairman, but any chairman. I believe it's the chairman's duty to determine who sets in on executive sessions. And I called him the other day. What's the executive session about? I seen him.
And that was my fault. Basically, told Becky to put it on, and when you
I
called me, I thought
it
was something else. That was my fault.
To inform the chairman.
So.
Melissa kind of would like, thinks that we should, each one of us should have some idea about it too, because she said that other than if you don't have an idea, it's pretty hard to make a decision. Right?
Yeah, and kind of on the spot.
Yeah.
Nice to know at least what it's about.
Okay.
Well, and a lot of times, if you call me, I can. If they don't tell me what it's going to be about, then I can tell you who called it, and then you can call them and ask them. But.
Okay. Anything else? Is there a motion to adjourn?
I don't.
Okay. We're adjourned.